Welcome, myself Giridhar Jain, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today, I am going to conduct a lecture on Common Source MOSFET Amplifier. Now, learning outcomes of the session are, at the end of the session, students will be able to draw the circuit of common source MOSFET amplifier using e-MOSFET and design biasing circuit for this amplifier. Contents: circuit diagram of common source MOSFET amplifier and design of biasing circuit. So figure shows the circuit for common source amplifier using n channel e MOSFET as shown in figure. So drain, source, gate. So from the gate resistance R1 and R2, resistance R1 goes to VDD and R2 goes to ground, and from the drain resistance RD connected to VDD, and from source resistance RS connected to the ground. So in this circuit, resistance R1, R2 and RS will act as biasing resistance. RD is load and this RL is the actual load, and C1 and C2 are the coupling capacitors which will block the DC and pass the AC. Vin is the input and phi out is the output which is connected to the external load RL. Supply voltage is VDD. On the right hand side you can see the DC load line and the transfer curve ID versus VGS, and the operating point is the point of intersection of this transfer curve and the load line, because the drain current flowing through RD and the drain current flowing through the MOSFET are same, because these are resistances and the MOSFET are connected in series, and therefore the operating point is point of intersection of this load line and the transfer curve as shown in figure. So operating point is Q. So at this operating point, VGS is VGSQ and this is IDQ. Okay. So applying KVL to the circuit, we can write VDD equal to IDRD plus VDS plus IDRS. Because the current flowing through RS is ID. So this can be simplified further to ID in the bracket RD plus RS, in terms of IDR combined together, plus VDS. And from this we can write down RD plus RS is equal to VDD minus VDS up by ID. Then from this equation we can write the expression for the RD. So RD equal to VDD minus VD, that is voltage at drain, so that will be voltage across RD, divided by ID, and the RS equal to voltage at the source divided by drain current ID. So at the MOSFET gate, so voltage between gate and source can be written as VGS is equal to voltage at gate minus voltage at source. So voltage at source is IS RS and the IS is ID. Okay. Now voltage at gate is obtained by the potential divider. So let us go back to the circuit. So for this circuit, voltage at gate is obtained So here resistance R1 and R2 will act as a potential divider between VDD and the ground, and therefore voltage DC voltage at the gate is R2 upon R1 plus R2 into VDD. So this is voltage at the gate. So voltage at gate is VDD R2 upon R1 plus R2. Okay. So here note that this voltage divider equation only determine the ratio of the two bias resistance R1 and R2. Okay. Also the desirable to make the values of these two resistance large so that the power loss across the resistance is small. Now MOSFET amplifier design example. So a common source MOSFET amplifier is to be constructed using n-channel e-MOSFET, which has a conduction parameter of 50 milliampere per volt square and the threshold voltage of 2 volt. If the supply voltage is 15 volt and the load resistance is 470 ohm, calculate the values of resistors required to bias the MOSFET amplifier at 1/3 VDD. So draw the circuit diagram. Values given are VDD equal to plus 15 volt, VTH 2 volt, and K equal to 50 milliampere per volt square, and RD given is 470 ohm. So drain current, so voltage at drain is taken VDD by 2, so 15 by 2, that is 7.5 volt. Then drain current is given by VD by RD, so 7.5 divided by 470 ohm is the RD given, and from that we calculate drain current as a 16 milliampere. Okay. Now get to source voltage. So ID is given by K in the bracket VGS minus VTH square, and K is given. So if we solve this equation, so VGS is equal to square root of ID by K plus VTH, substitute the values, so ID is 16 milliampere and K is 0.05, square root of that, plus VTH is 2 volt. So if we solve, we get VGS is 2.6 volt. Then VG is given as 1/3 of VDD, so VDD is 15 by 3, so that is 5 volt, and voltage at gate is VGS plus VG, and from this we obtain VS, voltage at source is VG minus VGS, so VG is 5 minus VGS is 2.6 volt, therefore VS is 2.4 volt. Thus applying KVL across the MOSFET, the drain source voltage VDS is given by, so here VDD, apply KVL, VDD is VD plus VDS plus VS, 15 volt, therefore VDS. Now VDS is, by substituting the values in the equation, VDD minus VD minus VS, so we will get 5.1 volt, that is VDS. Then source resistance RD is VS by ID, so VS is 2.4 divided by ID is 16 milliampere, so if we solve, we get RS equal to 150 ohm. Now VG is given by the equation R2 upon R1 plus R2 into VDD. So here 15 and it is 1/3. So VG we obtain as a 5 volt, and here a ratio of R2 upon R1 plus R2 is 1/3. Now pause this video and think on the following question. So how to select the values of R1 and R2? So for selecting the values of R1 and R2, so R1 and R2 should not be selected too low and too high. So select R1 is equal to 200 kilo ohm. Therefore R2 comes to be 100K, so that R2 upon R1 plus R2 will become 1 by 3. And R in is R1 parallel R2, so R1 is 200K and R2 is 100K, so parallel combination comes 67 kilo ohm. That is the input resistance of amplifier. Then for calculating the values of C1 and C2, let us select the lower cutoff frequency as 20 hertz. So that is given by 1 upon 2 pi R in into C. So substitute the values, and from this we calculate C is equal to 1 upon 2 pi 20 into 67 K. That is 0.12 microfarad. That is value of C1 and C2. So this is the complete circuit which shows R1, R2, RD, RS, all the component values. Okay. So in this way we complete the design of this common source amplifier using E MOSFET. So we have designed all the biasing resistors and the coupling capacitors C1 and C2. So these are the references. So thank you for watching the video.